Chapter 1. Loyalty has a vital place in the matters of nation building. As a citizen of a nation, there are many things expected of you. The paramount of those expectations is loyalty for the country and its interests. For a regular person, this quality is admirable, but it is a matter of life and death for a member of the Secret Service. Loyalty to your country is an essential quality in any individual. It keeps the nation growing and united. This reality was the case with a Russian spy, Oleg Gordievsky, a KGB agent born into the KGB, loved, formed, and almost destroyed. He was loyal to Mother Russia and the Secret Service. He loved his country and bought into the false message of uniting the world under the peaceful communal reign of the Soviet Union and thought joining its Secret Service would help him change the world. Loyalty can also be detrimental to the citizen as it is beneficial to the nation if done blindly. His loyalty, though, was blinding. He couldn't see that he was fighting for the wrong side. Unbeknownst to him, he was helping the enemy of the world change, grow, and spread. And as he slowly came to this realization, his loyalty began to waver and shift from Russia and the Soviet Union to the nearest beacon of freedom and hope, Great Britain. The thing with loyalty is it can be redirected to a much better cause and still be valid. So as Oleg Gordievsky began his descent from the lofty Soviet cause, he was found by agents from MI6 who needed someone to help them get inside intel from the KGB to take down the Soviet Union. In the following chapters, we will be introduced to the struggles Gordievsky faced in his mission to save the world, a world he no longer knew to be evil or good. Readers are given a front-row seat to the dismantling of what was considered an imminent threat to freedom and democracy, aided by a spy who believed he was on the right side, only to be awakened. Loyalty is an important trait, especially to one's nation. But what do you do when your country is the enemy? This was the dilemma Gordievsky was made to deal with. Two people can listen to the exact words and hear entirely different things. Ben Macintyre. Chapter 2. Into the World of Espionage. The Myth, the Gory Truths. Ben Macintyre officially introduces readers to yet another spy thriller for their ever-growing appetite for all things covert and mysterious. But what do we know about the world of spies and agents? Aside from the movie depictions, we barely have enough context on the reality of it. Thanks to the James Bond movies, we have bought into the false image of its panache and luxurious lifestyle, but that's far from the truth. Espionage isn't as it is depicted in movies. It's more profound and more dire. Espionage is the art or practice of spying or using spies, often by governments, to obtain political and military information or intelligence. Unlike the flair it is usually written to have, it is a much more sinister reality. It involves more tact, diplomacy, and information, and not the usual gunplay. The art of espionage involves a lot of finesse and calm plotting, and surprisingly, a lot of politics. Oleg Gordievsky was the quintessential spy, knowledgeable and blessed with a very prodigious memory. He used these skills and gifts to supply information to MI6 and even the CIA. He was instrumental in the Reagan-Thatcher coalition that would eventually lead to the fall of the Soviet Union. When sorrows come, they come not single spies, but in battalions, from Shakespeare's Hamlet, 1602. Spies are known to help topple governments, neutralize foreign threats, and do all of this without detection. Oleg Gordievsky embodied the core characteristics of the craft, and this made him invaluable. Thanks to his high intelligence and excellent memory, Gordievsky became one of the most remarkable spies in history. Espionage requires great tact and guile, making it a very effective and dangerous tool in warfare. The art of espionage is only as good as its reputation, hidden and done slyly. Oleg Gordievsky was able to keep his dealings with MI6 and the CIA separate and hidden from the KGB, preserving his integrity on both fronts. An immense feat, considering spies are under a great deal of scrutiny, and of course, spying themselves. Did you know? The Allied forces resorted to setting up the Cold War for one purpose only, to dismantle the Soviet Union. It started in 1946 and ended in 1991 when the Soviet Union collapsed. Chapter 3. Britain played a role in the collapse of the Soviet Union. Oleg Gordievsky struggled to place his loyalties. He felt an overwhelming doubt ever since he realized the evil his beloved Russia sought to wreak on the world. In his state of confusion, unsure what his next plan would be, he got a sign from the universe, interest from Britain's MI6 seeking to recruit him as a double agent. Sometimes we are forced to make hard choices for the greater good. When Gordievsky was posted by the KGB to Copenhagen in 1974, he had enough time away to think and question the workings of the KGB, Soviet Union, and his place in all of this. As an agent, he joined the Secret Service to be a catalyst of change, and whichever way he faced, be it Russia or the West, he was dedicated to making change. The realities of our goals can conflict with our desire to do good. It is essential to find a balance. When he was approached by the British in 1974 to become a double agent, Gordievsky was adamant about joining them. He agreed quickly because he felt uncomfortable with the Soviet agenda. He wanted to free the world of the threat that it posed. According to Macintyre, working for the Brits felt like the righteous thing to do. Sometimes when we wish to change the world, we must betray our old ideals. Surprisingly, he was able to work for MI6 for 11 years without the KGB catching wind of any of his business. He successfully supplied the intel needed by the opposition for a decade, and finally, he found true purpose. The Soviet Union was a threat to the people, and unknown to Gordievsky, he was helping further their agenda. Turning against them was vital to bringing them down and saving countless lives. Chapter 4. The Cold War had quite a few casualties. The Cold War is the offshoot of World War II, the aftermath of the power move of the Allied forces when they freed the world of the intending ill intents of the Nazi army and Germany's Hitler army. It was a war waged in various facets, economic, political, and even in media propaganda. The Cold War was the next phase after the Second World War, putting a new enemy against the Allied forces, the Soviet Union. Unlike the two world wars, the Cold War was fought with new weapons, no guns and no bombs, but with the art of espionage. This reality meant each nation had a barrage of spies whose tasks were to infiltrate other countries, industries, politics, and even media to perpetrate, sabotage, or obtain intel that would help cause the same destruction. The effectiveness of warfare is in attaining victory without any fighting. This is the place for espionage. The Cold War has been the sole reason the enemies of the U.S. have stayed powerless or without enough firepower to put up an actual attack. The modern world is a product of the Cold War's victories and losses. The advancements in technologies, the attempt by other nations to copy said advancements, and the success of these attempts are all down to the Cold War. The fronts where the Cold War was fought were not prominent, but had maximum damage to the nations. Fought by unseen armies that had soldiers like Oleg Gordievsky, the Cold War impacted the governments of the modern world, its corporations, and even their political and economic policies. The Cold War was fought by the U.S. against Russia and involved their allies, such as China, the UK, and France, which meant the target wasn't just one, but all involved. Since the players in the Cold War were so numerous, espionage became an international affair. Chapter 5. Ultimately, espionage is carried out for the love of country. As much as espionage is painted to look like a sinister art, the weapon of ill-meaning leaders and individuals with the intent to destroy and nothing else, the foundations are honorable. While the opposing sides might see a sinister individual, the spy acts on the love for their country. Espionage is built solely based on national interest, and it thrives. When a spy acts, it is in the interest of their country and a desire to do its bidding. Oleg Gordievsky joined the KGB because he loved his country and wanted to be a part of its glorious future. Great men are driven by their unwavering ideals and a desire to do something bigger than them. But soon, realizing that this love was based on a lie, he decided his love wasn't channeled properly and was now in need of a new recipient. Love for the country can be a very damning thing, and it almost brought destruction. Macintyre followed the life of Oleg Gordievsky when he was still entirely a KGB agent, and how it threatened to reduce his life to that of a mindless drone. We can become blinded by our desires to do right by ideals, so we must use this desire positively. Ironically, it was his love for the country that propelled him to accept Britain's offer. His goals had not changed. He still wanted to change the world, and although he tried to do it in line with the Soviets' vision, he no longer could. This difficulty in continuing in the Soviets' agenda was because he found out they had sinister plans of world domination, and many innocent lives would be hurt or lost. He must now change the world by saving his country, even if it meant destroying it first. Oleg Gordievsky is noted to have leaked vital KGB information to British intelligence through a series of discreet handoffs and correspondence that would ultimately prevent open nuclear war with America. This was his greatest accomplishment. Chapter 6. One may call spies traitors, but to the other side, they are saviors. The theme of this summary is that of betrayal and defection. It is the story of a spy who broke the trust of his fellow agents and his country in the process. Oleg Gordievsky was the quintessential spy, intelligent and intentional with the execution of his tasks. He used his skills to do the bidding of his nation so much that he was almost a casualty. Spies are loyal to the country and will use their vast talents to help achieve the nation's goals. When Russia viewed his career, though, they perceived it as a tale of betrayal and not loyalty or love for the country. This history is his legacy, and his status as a defector isn't one they will quickly forget. The scars he left were deep enough that his life was at risk. Knowing that his life was in grave danger, the wives of two British spies helped to smuggle Gordievsky through the border between Russia and Finland. He was almost discovered by hounds. But the ladies thought ahead and put used diapers and cheese in the trunk with him to mask his scent. In 1985, after a decade of working with Britain and the United States governments without being discovered once, his cover was blown, his life threatened. Although there was no solid evidence proving his crimes, the USSR charged him with treason, claiming he spied for a foreign power. There are suspicions that Aldrich Ames, a high-ranking CIA officer, was selling secrets to the KGB and might have been the one to expose Gordievsky's dealings to Russia. But for those 11 years, he was an active traitor in the eyes of the Soviet Union, and rightfully so. In his mind, he was only championing the survival of the modern world, free of the ideals by which the Soviet Union operated. The Spy and the Traitor is a fitting name, but Oleg Gordievsky was a savior to Russia and the modern world. Conclusion. The life and times of one of the world's most successful spies in history, Oleg Gordievsky, takes us through a barrage of events and occurrences with world change as a result. We get into the man's mind that the world tagged a hero, but his own country considered him a traitor. We also see just how hard it must have been to keep his loyalties in check without alerting the agency of his defection. The life of Oleg Gordievsky is one of espionage, loyalty, and an undying, untainted zeal and love for the country. These are the things that drove and shaped him in his life's choices. Ideally, he was trained and recruited by the KGB, and his loyalties lied with the Soviet Union. But once he learned he was fighting for the wrong side, he sought to correct the error in his morality and help change the world. Although Oleg Gordievsky loved his country, he knew that it had to be stopped. This feeling made it much easier to shift bases when the opportunity presented itself in recruitment by MI6 to help give them a picture of the thought processes of the leaders of the Soviet Union. This move was crucial for undoing and toppling the might of the Soviet Union through a swift play in the ever-cold war. Oleg Gordievsky is a real-life superhero who had to choose the greater good over his selfish desires. He defied Russia and opted to save the world instead, averting what would have been a massive nuclear event. Try this. When life presents you with the opportunity to affect significant change in the world through your profession, be ready, open-minded about it, and always make sure it isn't a purpose that's bound to cause more harm than good.